A lot of the fraternities would invite women and people from their fraternity. I was the only guy invited to all the parties. I was the first representative, campus representative from Anheuser-Busch to be on campus. Budweiser was the international language of acceptance, and so I would navigate between fraternity houses pretty readily. Nobody really had a hard time, with me being there.
It was a big ordeal finding a ride to the fraternity parties on the weekends. That was our biggest deal. What were you going to wear? And then how are you going to get there?
I think if you were cool, you were in the School of Business. If you weren't cool, you were like me and you were in the science building or somewhere else.
I don't know about that. Yeah. This was a big gathering spot. Regardless of your major, you came here to see your friends and sit around and talk about things.
The wall out in front of Dotson Cafeteria, in front of the highway that was there, that we used to sit on and just watch the scenery go by.
We would just hear this loud noise outside. We're like, what's that, what's that? And we'd run to the windows and it was the guys doing a panty raid. We looked for the biggest pair of panties we could find, an extra wall of granny panties, and threw those out at the window.
I know all the guys, we gathered in the lobby there to watch General Hospital, One Life to Live.
Luke and Laura were getting married and we meet at the end of the hall, you grab your pillow and you try to grab a spot because the spots would be taken and everybody would watch General Hospital.
In 1983, we had the amazing football team that won 12 games in a row, went to the national championship. The first time ever a Southern Conference team went to the national championship.
The three-pointer was in the pros, but it was new for college. And Ronnie Carr hit the first three-pointer, and that was our we were in spotlight.
I remember Bon Jovi came here in 1986. That was a huge deal because Bon Jovi was a huge deal in 1986.
We just enjoyed life. We laughed. We enjoyed our music. Mainly was just laughter and fun and enjoying life. And we were family.
There's something about Colorway and something about Western Carolina University that gets in you and it changes the way you think, the way you operate, and it's just the foundation to set us up for what God has blessed us with in terms of careers and families and so forth.
I tuned in quickly to the fact that I was developing relationships with these professors that were more than just in the classroom. They were interested in who I was as a person, and they invited me to their house for dinner and things like that.
It's hard to tell what I would have been. I mean, I met my wife here. My best friends.
I mean, we count our blessings because of the career and the education we got here.
I don't know where I'd be if I didn't go to Western. Yeah, we keep trying to give back to Western but we could never give Western back what they gave us. So.
I don't care if it's $10 a year. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter if it's just your time. I would come up here and lick envelopes for this place. I just would. Sometimes I get really emotional about it.
This is still home.
This is home. So much so I bought a house and I am going to retire here.
Knowing the kid that I was when I topped the and looked over Catamount Gap for the first time, and knowing the kid that I was when I went back over the Catamount Gap leaving for the last time, there are a lot of other people that want to experience a change like that. And if I can do any small thing to help facilitate someone else having a similar experience, I think that's worth something.